those or doing the job. So it goes back to an old, of all these corny sayings, but I used to develop at work is simplicity is the elegance of design. So there's a case, at least externally. You know, there's lots of horsepower inside the flex and things going on there, but you know, no racks of audio processing gear or anything like that. So good. And yeah, I saw your post about the restringing the tower, and I have to do it. It's kind of ironic because I have to do the same thing. Mine has not broken yet. But, you know, you look at the cable, it's been about 5, 6, 7 years, and I put all the grease on it, and you know, it just doesn't last very long. I used a very good, I actually bought the replacement cable from U.S. Tower. And, so this time, my buddy knew a shop that makes stainless cable, custom stainless cables, to make it any length, and put ferrules on the end, and things like that, so gave me as a gift replacement cables for my tower. I gave them the old set and I had from two times ago, and they made them up exactly the same. And the strength is no problem, and they're stainless now. And hopefully, you know, I won't have to do this very much. And I was thinking about whether to do it at all because I have I bought from a friend of mine because he kind of got out of radio. I bought an aluminum tower. It goes up, I don't know, 72 foot. It's I'm trying to even remember the name. Heights, maybe Heights made it. And a beautiful tower. It's probably 20 inches at the base, and goes up from there. And it's really a nice tower. His cable broke on his, and that's why I got it at kind of an inexpensive price. I think I paid him $500 for it. So, some of the Heliarc welds will need to be replaced, and I'll probably put some new pulleys on it and things like that. But basically, it's in very good shape, and I'll replace my current tower. But you know how those projects go. You say, "Yeah, I'm going to do that next summer," and then there's always other things next summer, and it doesn't get done. So I just mentioned to Martha I want to crank the tower down that I have now and put all new cables on it, and at least I know it'll be secure for the winter. Mine is a tower pole, I guess you would call it. It's made by U.S. Tower. It's the MB550, and it has the rotating base on it, and you know, cranks down and tilts over, and is the hinge base, and the rotor actually mounts almost at ground level. There's a big bearing, thrust bearing, and then the whole tower spins. And it's, I think, 55, 56 foot, and then I have a 2-inch thick wall aluminum mast that comes out of the top. So it gets me up to about 65 feet. I have the inverted V for 160, open wire line fed, and that's the current antenna I'm on. So it's been very good. It's been a great tower. You know, you can't put tons of antennas on it, but you could put, you know, the typical Mosley tri-bander, a TA-33, or and some verticals and some dipoles, and it's no issue there. But you know, if you want to do stack monobanders for 10, 15, and 20, unless you put guys on it, I think you'd be stretching it a bit. So that's a project that I have to dial in yet, for sure. Okay, Rob, I see it's about 6 minutes before 12, and I got till 12 o'clock here. I'm going to turn it back over to you so I can hear your final transmission to me for this session, and then you may want to turn it over to my good friend Kim, KE3SX, up there in north central PA, halfway between lost and found, as he always says on the air. Your transmitter sounds fantastic, and I that's the amplifier that I'm using. I've modified it a little bit with step start and some other changes just for a little bit more robustness, but I've had this AL82 for probably 10, 12 years, and it's been just great. It's been really, really good. I had some initial problems while using it on AM, and I found the watt meter on the front wasn't calibrated, and I was running lots more power than I thought I was, and had some problems with the 3500s, the power that I was actually running. So we recalibrated the watt meter against the bird, and you may want to check that on yours. and it's performed well, and I run it consistently on AM at 300 to 350 watts output. And the blower on the high speed position, and it's been going 10, 12 years, same tubes, no issues, no problems. So it's really, really worked out well. W1AEX with K3SX in the bucket. This is W3GMS.